श्रुति नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ हुनक्तु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहैः। ओम शांति शांति शांति। श्री चिद्गण गणेशाय नमो। मह्यम सुखम नित्यम सत्प्रकाशम व्यापकम नाम रूपयो बुद्धि अपारम सर्ववेदांत। सो आई फॉरगॉट द प्रेयर आल्सो। सुखम नित्यम सत्प्रकाशम व्यापकम नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्व निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेव अहन्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं ये वेदांश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुं हदेवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। सो यस्टरडे वी लुक्ड एट द 124th आवर्त where the putras also like raja they also had jihasa rajya jihasa and then they approached the guru leaving the trailoka rajya further in 126th tattva drishtir gurur anumatim prarthayate so after his brothers you know kind of gestured to him that why don't you ask he understood the gestures and then with folded hands he asked the guru he bhagavan vayam trayopi bhrataraha shubhasantatehe rajnyah kumaraha ajnyah atyantam suchyah nijaswarupa jignyasavah bhavantam sharanam gataha he introduces himself where they are from all the questions which have been asked you know kena prayojanen agata and then kuyam kutovatra आगमनम दीज आर द क्वेश्चंस दैट द गुरु हैड आस्क्ड सेज ओ भगवान वयम त्रयापि वी आर ब्रदर्स एंड वी आर चिल्ड्रन ऑफ दिस राजा शुभसंतति कुमारः वी आर यंग बट अज्ञः वी आर इग्नोरेंट अत्यंतम शोच्याः एंड शोच्या मींस समबडी हु वी आर इन अ पिटिएबल स्टेट वी आर इन अ पिटिएबल स्टेट So although we have everything at our disposal, still we have dukkha. We are looking for ananda. Nijaswarupa jijnyasavaha. We want to know our real nature. Therefore, bhavantam sharanam gataha. Therefore, we have approached, taken refuge into you. Bhavan hi krupa samudraha. And then he praises the guru. He says, you are krupa samudra. We have watched you over for 6 months. Kalpataru. चिंतामणि कामधेनुवच्च विराजते एंड द वे यू नो वे यू कैरी यूर सेल्फ वी सी दैट यू आर अ कल्पतरु चिंतामणि कामधेनुवच्च सो ऑल दिस सो विश फुलफिलिंग ट्री और अ काउ विश फुलफिलिंग काउ एंड चिंतामणि ऑल्सो विच यू नो विच ऑल्सो हैज सम मैजिकल पावर्स वयम तु दुख वशम वदाह On the other hand, we are under the influence of dukkha. We are under the pressure of dukkha all the time, under the control of dukkha. Although we want sukha just like everyone else, still we cannot but give unto dukkha circumstantially which comes across. Yadi ajnya diyate, further. तर्हि अस्मदभिप्रायं निवेदयाम इति तत्त्वदृष्टि प्राह सो तत्त्वदृष्टि आस्क्ड इफ यू परमिट देन विल आस्क अभिप्रायं निवेदयाम देन अस्मदभिप्रायं विल आस्क आस्क ऑफ सम डाउट्स हे शिष्य सो द गुरु सेज हे शिष्य श्रुणु मे वचः लिसन टू माय वर्ड्स तच्छ्रवणेन त्वद्हृदय ग्रंथया संशयाश्च समूलन समूलं उन्मूलिता भवेयुः सो यू लिसन टू माय वर्ड्स माय टीचिंग एंड लिसनिंग टू दीज श्रवणेन श्रवण मात्रेण त्वद हृदय ग्रंथयः संशयाश्च योर डाउट्स एज वेल एज दी अविद्या ग्रंथी हृदय ग्रंथी इज अविद्या ग्रंथी विच लीड्स टू अध्यास ऑल दोज विल गो समूलम इट विल गो अलॉन्ग विद दी रूट कॉज उन्मूलिता भवेयु एंड इट इज नॉट दैट इट विल गो एज एन यू कट सम वीड्स दे ग्रो बैक He says, Unmulita Bhaveyu means they will be uprooted so that it will never come back. The avidya and its avidya karya will never come back again. They will get uprooted. Tancha Paramananda Prapniyaha. And you who is Socha in a pitiable state grieving, you will attain Paramananda. Iti Gurur Avochata. So he replied in this manner, the Guru. Further, Mumuksha Abhivyanjaka, Tattva Drishti Prashnaha. So Tattva Drishtehe Prashnaha. What is the question of Tattva Drishti? The Uttama Adhikari, son, who is speaking on behalf of others as well. He asked a question which shows the Mumuksha. It indicates Mumuksha. श्री गुरोः कारुण्यं ज्ञात्वा हृदयानंद संदोह तुंदिलः सन् तत्वदृष्टिः स्वाभिलषित कार्यं सिद्धं इति निश्चित्य सविनयं पप्रच्छ सुस तत्वदृष्टि पप्रच्छ ही आस्क्ड हैविंग हर्ड द गुरु यू नो व्हेन द गुरु हैज कंफर्टेड यू कैन आस्क एनीथिंग दैट यू वांट I'll clear all your doubts and you will definitely reach your goal. So, Shri Guruho Karunyam Nyatva, having known the compassion of the Guru, such a compassion of the Guru, Hrudayananda Sandoha Tundilaha. So, Tundilaha is basically, you know, fattening up. Tundila. But here, Tundila's son means how basically his heart is filled with So, heart is filled. Actually, we see that he is fulfilled. Generally, fulfillment we associate with some kind of hunger or thirst being fulfilled. So, here similarly, you know, comparison is given. Tundila, his stomach full. Not literally, but stomach full of milk. Sandoha. Sandohena Tundilaha. And what kind of sandoha? Sandoha is milk. From the milk, which is Ananda Rupa. So, sandoham, sandoha yuva sandoha. It is not real milk, but it is hridayananda. Hridayananda, which is like milk, and from that he is like a child which is craving for mother's milk. And then becomes satisfied. Similarly here, like a parent, the guru has, guru's words have been so fulfilling that there is hridayananda utpatti, and from that itself, you know, his hunger is satiated. He is completely happy and tattva drishti then swabhilashita karyam siddham iti nischitya. He jumps the gun. He says that I have got a guru, and having got a guru who is willing to take away my doubts and reach me to the goal, therefore swabhilashita karyam siddham, as good as attained, my goal is as good as attained, iti nischitya savinayam paprachya. He asked with all humility, Hey Bhagavan, O Lord, Bhavan Krupanidhi, you are a treasure of compassion, Shri Sadashiva Dakshinamurti Samaha Sarvajnaha. You are a Sarvam Janati iti Sarvajnaha. You know everything, so you can clear all my doubts because you are comparable to Swayam Dakshinamurti the Adi Guru. Sadashiva Dakshinamurti Samaha Sarvajnaha Bhavan. Vayam tu sarve ajnaha. However, we all of us, we brothers are ajnaha. We do not know much. We just know some worldly things. We do not know much. Janana Maranadi Dukkha Rupa Samsara Bibhimaha. And we we are scared of this samsara due to this samsara from bhaye panchami. So bhaye panchami samsara dvibhimah, scared of this samsara. Which kind of a samsara? Dukkha roopa. It is a dukkha roopa samsara. What kind of dukkha? Lot of dukkha, janana marana adi. So janana, janma, marana, and between janana and marana adi, everything in between is dukkha roopa. Janana is dukkha roopa, definitely. Not for the parents. Parents are happy when the child is born, the child is crying. Because it has gone through so much of pain of birth. The mother goes through pain, but she is happy looking at the child. The father painlessly is happy. Then marana, marana samaya is dukkha roopa because of the disease. People say, you know, I'm not scared of death, but the process of death is scary. The process of death is dukkha roopa. Adi padena, everything that is between janana and marana is dukkha roopa. That kind of samsara bibhimaha vayam tu asmakam tannivritte paramananda praptescha upayo vaktavya. So you have to tell us, you know, you should, being, what is the hetu? Krupanidhi. Being krupanidhu, krupanidhi, Shri Sadashiva Dakshinamurti samaha sarvajnya, you will know a way out. You definitely know a way out. So you should tell us a upaya. Vaktavyaha. What upaya for what? Tannivrittehe. Asmakam tannivrittehe is dukkha roopa samsara. And then tadjanya bhitihi. The fear which is born of samsara will not go unless samsara goes away. That sounds to take away that samsara and samsara janya dukkha bhaya. For us, asmakam tannivritti, and not only that nivritti, but paramananda praptescha, which you have said, the Guru has done made a pratijna, paramananda prapnuyaha tvamcha, you will attain. So here, he says you have made a commitment, please help us out, paramananda praptescha upayo vaktavya, bhavadvi, you should be telling us the way out. Nana prakara upasanani karmani cha anushtitani. So if the Guru asks, okay, have you tried anything before this? He says, nana prakara upasanani karmani cha. It is not that I have just, you know, knocked on your door one fine day, washed my face and then, okay, let me find a Guru. He says, I have tried to get paramananda, parikshalokan, karmachitan, brahmano, nirveda maya. And then, so Guru meva avigachet. Samit Pani. So accordingly, he says, Nana Prakara Upasanani Karmani Cha Anushtitani. I have done all the karma which is prescribed in various ways. They are revealed by the Shastra. Not easily findable solutions also I have found, but they have not led me to Dukkha Nivritti and Paramananda Prapti of the order I am looking for. It has not led to Nityananda. There is still Dukkha continuing. So karma and upasanas have helped, but na eva asmad abhilashitartha siddhirabhut. What we wanted, we didn't get. What I was looking for is Paramananda, which is Nitya. But I did not get through upasana and karmas. I have done it for a long, long time. We all have done it. Pratyuta. Samsaratmaka bandha eva dridi bhavati. But what has happened is that as long as I do some dhyana, upasana, there is some happiness there. But then it is binding because every time I need to tap that. It is not long lasting. It may be lasting as long as I am in dhyana. So something of that sort, pratyuta. However, what has happened is that samsaratmaka bandha eva dridi bhavati. So instead of being attached to some vishaya, I am attached to upasana now. But still, the samsaratmaka bandha continues one way or the other. It is bandha. There is no mukti inside. Tasmat yena upayantarena vayam krithartha bhavema tam upayam asman shadi bhoho. So please teach us an upaya which will lead us to become krutartha. Yena upayantaran, because we know that upasana and karmas we know, and we know that they don't lead to moksha. So please tell us some other upaya which will make us krutartha. Please teach us. Shadhi is please teach us. Lot lakara madhyama purusha ekavachana. So jnanopadesha. Guru starts giving the jnanopadesha. Now keeping in mind, Tattva Drishti has asked the question and we have done karmas and upasanas. So Guru will start teaching at a higher level. Since karma and upasana has been done, he starts teaching at a very high level. Shishyasya mokshechha bhranti janya iti upapadana purvakam mahavakyartho upadesha. Not even mahavakya upadesha in that sense, you know, building up something and then giving mahavakya, nothing of the sort. Directly mahavakya upadesha, that too, the starts with the conclusion of the mahavakya. No bhagatyaga lakshana. Those who have studied bhagatyaga lakshana, we've seen in Tattva Bodha, at least the bare minimum expected is Tattva Bodha. Where even bhagatyaga lakshana is done, some chapters of Panchadashi, Viveka Chudamani, Dirgdrishya Viveka, wherever you go, bhagatyaga lakshana. Jahad, otherwise called as Jahad Ajahal lakshana. So when Tattvamasi is taught, what is Tat? Ishvara. Tom is this Jiva. So Tat and Tom, on the face of the equation, they are contradictory. So we have to remove what is contradictory and hold on to what is common. That is Jahad Ajahal lakshana. Give up the bhaga and hold on to. You do a tyaga of bhaga and hold on to what is common, underlying commonality, without the adjectives, without the limitations of the upadhi. Guru is doing none of that. Why? Because he says, when the mumuksha is seen, when the shishya wants moksha now, he's tried the upayas, then first he should give the teaching and see if that works. If that works, nothing else is needed. He's free here and now at that moment. When there are questions, then there is more. Some keep on explaining what is not asked. What he is asked is, I want Paramananda Sukha, one upaya for that. If the direct teaching works, let it be. It may work for some. So the Guru starts teaching the artha of the Mahavakya. So Jnanopadesha is what? The initial Jnanopadesha is Shishyasya Mokshecha Bhranti Janya Iti Upapadana Purvakam. Explaining this Mahavakyartha Upadesha. He tells what is the meaning of the Mahavakya. The resultant is this. Your moksha ichcha itself is invalid. Bhranti janya. Why? Because bandha is bhranti janya. So moksha ichcha will be what? Bhranti janya. If one understands that, then one can drop everything at that very moment. So with that in mind, Guru starts teaching. Atyantika dukkha nivrittihi paramananda praptischa mokshaha iti kathyate. First he says what you are looking for, that paramananda prapti and dukkha nivritti. We have seen this in the very definition of moksha in the first chapter. Atyantika dukkha nivritti. Complete dukkha nivritti. Such that nothing remains. None of the dukkha remains and paramananda praptihi. There are some who say, oh, dukkha nivritti is there, you know. Some who have followed Buddhism, especially. You know, they say, we go for vipassana and go on for a week, 10 days of vipassana. And after that, there is dukkha nivritti. Feel that. Because mauna. Mauna initially is difficult. But in mauna, there is some sukha because a lot of withdrawal from talking, which waste energy, which is dukkha rupa. And due to talking, there are misunderstandings and more dukkha. Finally, what one lands on is cessation of dukkha, even in mauna. So, atyantika dukkha nivritti is not possible. It appears that there is dukkha nivritti because what do they say? Buddhist says sarvam dukkham, sarvam dukkham, sarvam dukkham. Everything is trivara. Not even once they'll keep on saying it. Everything is dukkha rupa. But Paramananda is not there. They do not talk about ananda at all. They talk about dukkha nivritti. There is everything is dukkha. You run away from everything. But how will you run away from yourself? That you who is with the body mind complex will be there with you wherever you run away. It's pouring. Let me just close the window. So even in cessation of all activities, physical and mental, there is one's own swarupa there, which if misunderstood does not manifest. It may manifest in one way or the other, but if one does not know that the source is unknown, then one will keep on getting addicted to shunya, meaning samsara shunyatvam. However, aikya is not known. So these shunyavadis do not have paramananda prapti. So an example, therefore paramananda prapti is mentioned to show shruti gata, what is revealed in the shruti as the swarupa of one's own atma, meaning one's own swarupa. Rahu shirovat shashti. So one is ananda rupa. There is no doubt about this. There should not be any doubt about it. Therefore, atyantika dukkha nivritti paramananda praptischa mokshaha iti kathyate. Shishyasya mokshecha nyatva guruhu tad upaya bhutam vedantaika samadigamyam jnanam upadishati. Which jnana does he teach? Not any jnana. Vedantaika samadigamyam. Which is known only through Vedanta, ai eka, not Vedanteshu api, Vedanteshu eka samadigamyam, only in Vedanta. So anyone who says in any language, any part of the world, someone says, you know, I don't need any teacher, I don't need any Vedanta, I don't need any religion also, I am free. Any person, any, you know, belonging to any religion can be free. We do not deny the possibility, but that person has necessarily known it in some janma, or someone has taught him who has known it in some janma through Vedanta, because no other text is apaurishya. Only apaurishya work which is in the form of text now is Vedanta, Shruti, Veda. Veda is knowledge, and that knowledge is there in the written form available now, which may have been a source for other works of other religions possible, or some, you know, random book, some Tom, Dick and Harry teaching somewhere. But still, the source has to be Shruti, because nobody can land on it by oneself. Nobody can land. One may land on one's own Swarupa, but not on Aikya. Because Aikya with the Creator cannot be known on one's own. One who has known has necessarily has had some samskara from Purva Janma. There is no doubt about it. Therefore, Vedantaika Samadhi Gamyam Jnanam Upadishati. Knowing, Shishya wants moksha. It is not that Shishya wants something and Guru is giving something else. So, Mokshecham Nyatva Guru Tad Upaya Bhutam. What is the Upaya? That jnana is the upaya for moksha, which is in the form of dukkha nivritti, atyantika dukkha nivritti and paramananda prapti. Jnana swarupasya nana shastreshu nana prakarena uktatve api. Even if the jnana swarupa is detailed in many ways in many shastras, still the jnana which will lead to moksha is jiva brahma bheda nivartaka jnana seva moksha sadhanatvena vedeshu pratipaditatvat. Since the jnana which leads to moksha is revealed only in the Shruti, Vedeshu Pratipaditatvat, as moksha sadhana. Which jnana? Jiva Brahma Bheda Nivartaka Jnana. the jnana which is not teaching aikya really. Through aikya, through tattvamasi ityadi mahavakyas, what is being taught is not aikya. What is being taught is through aikya, bheda nivritti is being taught, because bheda is set in. If someone tells you are one, if he holds on to one and then bheda also, it won't work. So even in mandukya, even in the mandukya prakriya, it is neti neti prakriya. Each and every prakriya finally is neti neti prakriya, including tattvam masi. Although is it a positive, it is a positive statement, you are that Ishvara. Still, what it means is that you are not delimited jiva. You are not different from Ishvara. That bheda nivritti should take place. Then aikya is not needed, because the bheda is opposing the aikya which is already there. If the bheda is removed, then aikya is svatah siddha. There is nothing else needed. The teaching works in the manner of negating the dvaita prapancha, negating the bhedas, all sorts of bhedas. We have seen jiva jiva bheda, jiva ishvara bheda, jiva jada bheda, ishvara jada bheda. And we have seen these five bhedas. Jiva jada, jiva ishvara, ishvara jada, ishvara jiva, and jiva jiva. So all five bhedas are negated. So jiva, here specifically aikya is taught between the jiva and ishvara, because jiva needs moksha, not the jada. Although the five abhedas, abheda will include the nivritti of all the five, still the abheda is taught between jiva and brahma, ishvara. Jiva brahma bheda nivartaka jnanasya eva moksha sadhanatvam. Jiva brahma bheda nivartaka jnana, that alone will, any jnana which will take away the difference between jiva and brahma, that jnana alone will be moksha sadhana. And being moksha sadhana tvena vedeshu pratipaditattva, that is how it is revealed in the Shruti, in the Vedas. Therefore, tadrisham eva jnanam upadishati. Therefore, guruhu tadrisham eva jnanam, not any other jnana, this jnana which will take away Brahma and Jiva Bheda. What is the teaching he gives? He shishya paramananda vaptau janana maranadi dukkha rupa samsara nivruttau cha tava utpannecha bhranti janya iti avehi. May you know, iti avehi, lotlakara again, madhya purusha ekvachana. May you know that this Ichha of what? Ichha moksha prapti. What kind of moksha prapti? Paramananda avapti and janana maranadi dukkha rupa samsara nivritti. Twofold achievement that you are looking for, that itself which is born, utpanna ichha, this ichha which is born in you to attain paramananda and give up all the dukkha, dukkha rupa samsara, that ichha itself is bhranti janya. Very shocking. My moksha ichha itself is bhranti janya. Yatastvam, why he gives reason, not just making some, you know, shooting in the dark. Yatastvam nisargataha eva niratishaya paramananda swarupasi. Why so? Because by very nature, nisargataha, your very nature is like that. Your nature is niratishaya paramananda swarupa. Nobody can take it away. Even in the worst of the dukkha, you are of the nature of paramananda. Therefore, trying to get this paramananda, which is your own swarupa, is definitely bhranti janya. That ichha is bhranti janya. It is like saying, you know, show me the moon. You're looking at the moon and you ask someone, please show me the moon. This is the moon. No, you show me the moon. It would be very foolish if one is looking at the moon and asks, But the problem is, one is not looking at the moon. One closes the eyes and says, show me the moon. Even the sun. Show me the sun. You close your eyes and say, show me the sun. I can't see the sun. But even with closed eyes, the light that enters your eyelids, even with the closed sun in broad daylight, you cannot miss it. Even with closed eyes, what you see is the sun. Within the light that pierces through the eyelids is the sunlight. However, we do not know the sun. Every vishaya that is cognized, shabda sparsha roopa rasa gandha, every thought, every buddhigata vritti, every buddhi vritti is manovritti, is due to atma. Every cognition is due to, every bodha is due to atma. Therefore, Keno Upanishad teaches pratibodha viditam matam. You cannot miss your own swarupa, following which everything is. Each cognition, if I say I hear something, I see something, I taste something, the I pervades through and through. How can you miss it? But we happen to miss it because our focus is on shabda sparsha roopa rasa gandha, not the cognizer, me. So yatastam nisargatha eva niratishaya paramananda swaroopasi tasmat tava utpannecha mokshecha bhranti janya eva iti avehi tasmat sada paramananda swaroopena eva sataha tava punaha tat prapti ichha na yujyate. Therefore, it is not tenable that you already are of the nature of Paramananda, and you, one who is sataha Paramananda swarupena eva sataha tava. So one who, for you, who is already in the form of Paramananda, punaha tat prapti ichha, tat prapti ichha Paramananda prapti ichha. Na yujyate, it would be illogical. Therefore, that is bhranti janya. We end up doing illogical things because of delusion. Yanna praptam tallabha eva uchite ichha. Ichha is uchita. When yanna praptam, towards something which is not attained, tallabhaya. What is not attained? Towards that, if you have Ichha, I agree that it would make sense. But then you already are of that nature. This Ichha is not valid. It is not Uchita. Uchita Ichha na bhavati. Why? Because Paramananda swarupena eva asitvam. You are in that form already. So what do you need to do? If one understands this teaching, you give up everything that you associated with. Your swarupa is Paramananda. Tvat swarupam tu tvaya sarvada praptam eva ityataha tat praptaye tava jayamane chha brahmamantara na sangachyate. Although you do have ichha, that ichha is not being logical. Ichha not being logical. What is that ichha due to? Brahmamantarana sangachyate. Wouldn't be possible without Brahma. So Brahmitoasi, you are deluded. Because Tvatswarupam tu tvaya sarvada praptamiva. It is always attained. Even when you are fast asleep, dreaming a nightmare, or dreaming of Ishara, whether you are in the worst of the dukkha or sukha, in the waking state, till sarvada praptameva. That is what is swarupa. If something that comes and goes, you consider it as swarupa, it is not your swarupa. The very definition of swarupa is that which cannot come and go, which is not agantuka. That which is agantuka cannot be swarupa. Swarupa by definition is that which is ever there. Thereby sarvada praptameva ityataha tat praptaye tava jayamane cha brahmamantara na sangachyate. Without Brahma, it is not possible to have this kind of a moksha ichha. Kincha जनन मरणादि रूप संसारो यदि कदाचित त्वयि अभूत एंड यू से ओके लेट मी बी परमानंद स्वरूप व्हाट अबाउट दिस दुख दैट आई हैव संसार दुख इज स्टिल देयर यू आर टेलिंग मी आई एम परमानंद स्वरूप लेट मी हाइपोथेटिकली एक्सेप्ट दैट आई एम परमानंद स्वरूप व्हाट अबाउट दिस दुख रूप संसार आई फील दिस दुख इज रियल How do I get away from that? Let me assume that the second part of moksha is attained as Paramananda Prapti. Although I don't feel it, let me say it as my own Swarupa. What about this Dukkha Rupa Samsara? Kincha Janana Maranadi Rupa Samsara Yadi Kadachit. Sometime had that Samsara been in you, Toi Abhut. Yadi Kadachit. Had it been there, Tada Tava Tan Nivruttaye Iccha Uchita Bhavet. Had the samsara been there, you should have struggled. You could struggle for dukkha nivritti. But this samsara, yadi kadachit means what? Had it been there sometime, that samsara. Vastutastu sa samsara ishadapi kalatrayapi nastyevattvai. But that samsara is not in you at all. Samsarittvam is not possible for atma. Which atma? That which is Paramananda, Sarupa. So this Dukkha Nivritti also is Bhranti Janya. Iccha, Dukkha Nivritti Iccha is also Bhranti Janya. Dukkha Nivritti Iccha. Because Vastutaha, in reality, Vastutastu, Sa Samsaraha, Ishadapi, not even a little, Kalatrayapi, not even at any point of time, Nasti Eva Tvayi. It is not that you'll get moksha one day and then samsara will go away. Samsara was never there in you. Tasmat kalatraya pyavidyamanasya samsara dukkhasya nivivritsa te brahma mantarana ghatate. So that nivritti iccha that you have. Nivritti iccha that you have for samsara dukkha. Samsara dukkha should go away. Which kind of samsara dukkha? Which you think is existent, but avidyamanasya samsara dukkhasya nivritti. Nivivritsa te brahmamantarana ghatate. It is not possible, tava, for you it is not possible to have this iccha also. You do have iccha, I agree that you have iccha, but that iccha is also bhranti janya. Because the samsara dukkha is avidyamana. There is no samsara dukkha at all because samsara itself is not there in you. This dukkha rupa samsara can be there only if samsara is there. Samsara is not there. Where is the samsara? It is not there at all. He shishya tvantu janana maranadi sarva samsara shunya chinmatra swarupa brahma evasi. What you really are janana maranadi sarva samsara. That dukkha swarupa samsara which you have said, dukkha rupa samsara, janana maranadi rupa. You, however, are janana maranadi sarva samsara shunya. You are without this janana maranadi sarva samsara shunya, but does not mean you are shunya. You are free from samsara, bereft of samsara, which has janana marana. But you yourself by nature are Chinmatra. So Chinmatra Swarupa Brahma Evasi. That Brahma which is taught in the Shastra, that you are. So this is Tattvamasi Mahavakya in closing. Tasmat Masmara Kadapi Janana Maranadi Dukkha Rupam Samsaram. So what do you need to do? You do not remember this samsara at all. Whatever memory you have of samsara, let it go. We hold on to it. Oh, I am this person. I am this man. I am this woman. I have a parent. I have parents. I have children. I have brothers, sisters, friends, enemies, relatives. I have bosses and subordinates. I have this work. I have this entire world against me. Because I just can't do anything for myself. I want moksha, but the samsara has trapped me. All this is in memory. Masmara. Don't hold on to it. Let it go. How do I let it go? Then stay there. Then dukkha will be there. How do I let it go? First he says, this is Brahmastra. Tasmat masmara kadapi janana maranadi dukkha rupam samsara. If you can just it is not that you know leave it without the jnana. Jnana is already given. You are chinmatra swarupa brahma. Once you are that and samsara is not there in you, then what do you need to do? Simple teaching, just let it go. How do you let it go? Any which way you can let it go. Anything that you see is binding, cannot bind you, you just let it go. Initially, at least withdraw yourselves physically. Stop interacting with the world the way you did earlier. Change your attitude. All this is there in this simple Sangraha Vakya. Tasman Masmara Kadapi Janana Marana Dukkha Rupam Samsaram Eva Masmara. Don't recall, don't hold on to your memories saying that, oh, you know, in my childhood I struggled so much. I am a self-made man. You are not self-made man. You are the self. Where is the making? You are unfortunately self-made and therefore you are a man or a woman. That self-made, you are trying to make yourself, which is binding. Kartrutvam is binding. Bhoktrutvam is enforced because Kartrutvam is binding. Or Kartrutvam is due to Bhoktrutvam, that I want Bhoga. Which I have, I want to give away. What I don't have, I want. So that Kartrutva, which is binding, Bhoktrutvam, which is binding, comes about only when you hold on to it. It is not possible without holding on to memories. And once you held to them, then being a karta bhokta, you are a samsari. Then you cannot avoid janana maranadi dukkha rupa samsara. Therefore, how do you step out? Know that you are already free from it and let it go. Atra akshepa samadhana. So Shishya has heard, but not easy. Even for an uttama adhikari, not easy. Sorry. So, sukha vishayaka akshepa samadhanani. The shishya has doubts about this sukha rupa that guru is talking about. Atma swarupa is sukha rupa. Atmana ananda rupatve vishaya sambandad ananda bhanam na uchitam iti akshepaha. So, shishya says, I have vishaya sambandad ananda. Ananda, I have this experience of ananda. So many years I have experienced with any Vishaya that I want. When I get that Vishaya, there is a Vishaya Sambandha and thereby there is Ananda in me. There is Ananda Utpatti. So Ananda Rupatvi Sati. If Ananda Rupa was there, then I wouldn't get this Vishaya Sambandha Sukha. I am getting Vishaya Sambandha Ananda means that Ananda is Vishaya Sambandha Janya. It cannot be Atma Swarupa, Atmana Ananda Rupatve, Vishaya Sambandad Ananda Bhanam Na Uchitam. There won't be a possibility of Ananda Utpatti due to Vishaya Sambandha, but there is, therefore, Anyatha Anupapatya. Arthapatti Pramana shows that Atma cannot be Ananda Rupa. So what you have taught, I have heard, but I do not understand it because I have Vishaya Sambandha Ananda, Natu Atma Ananda. He Swamin, Mama Atma, my Atma. Again, Raho Shirovat Shashti, but He Swamin, Mama Atma, Yadi Nitya Niratishaya Paramananda Rupa Eva Bhavati. Had it been so that what you have taught is my nature is Ananda, very Swarupa is Ananda Rupa, Tada Vishendriya Sambandha Jinataya Atmani Ananda Anubhava Naupapadyetha. Upapadyeta tu. It would not be possible for me to have Ananda in Atma. Ananda Anubhava in Atma. This Anubhava that I have in myself, that I am happy. When I get what I want with the Vishaya, I have Indriya Sambandha. And my Ananda is Adhina. Ananda Anubhava is Adhina. Is dependent on the connection between the Indriya and the Vishaya. If I like what I see, then I have Ananda. My eyes come in contact with the Vishaya that I like to see, then there is this Sambandha dependent Atmananda Anubhava. अनुभूयते एव हाउएवर आई हैव दिस विषय संबंधात आत्मनि आनंद अनुभूयते एव तु विषय संबंधात आत्मनि आनंद आई डू हैव दिस आनंद ड्यू टू विषय संबंध तस्मात् नैव आनंद स्वरूप आत्मा therefore आत्मा cannot be आनंद स्वरूप किंतु what is the reality विषय संबंधात एव आत्मनि आनंदो जायते the ananda is born in atma due to vishaya sambandha it is not my real nature but vishaya does something to me and then it brings about ananda we'll stop here we'll continue in the next part where we'll see ajnyasya vishaya pravruttau satyam tadiyantar mukha vruttau atmanando bhati visheshu nasti ananda iti samadhanam the samadhana to this is we'll see in detail that the briefly when there is vishaya pravrutti then one does not remain antarmukhi one becomes bahya vrutta and thereby being focused outward once ananda is lost and one keeps on hunting ananda outside once this vishaya is attained then one drops this pursuit going outward remains inward and then the ananda which is one's own swarupa manifests we'll see this in the next part सुखम नित्यम सुप्रकाशम व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धि बोध्यं बुद्धिर्दृक्यत्व निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेव अनुमत्योन्यत इति मे निश्चिता मतिः तत्सत् इफ देयर आर एनी क्वेश्चंस आई विल टेक इट लेटर लेट फॉर अनदर पाठ नमस्ते
नमस्ते